In class 11 business studies, we are on the last topic of last chapter. And the last chapter is international business. And in international business, today we are going to start the export and export process. Okay, so in this video, I am going to explain you about international business, how to do that international business. With the help of export and import means tangible goods which we can export to other countries and import from other countries. So, see, in this video, you will come to know about export and import process, how to, if you want to do international business, the easiest way to enter into the international business is export and import. Okay. So first of all, see, the exporter first step, the receipt of inquiry and sending quotations. This is the first step which is in the export process. Receipt of inquiry and sending quotation means the importer will send the inquiry about the quality, quantity, price, terms and condition. So the exporter will receive the inquiry from the importer who is sitting in any corner of the world, and then accordingly he will send the quotation. It contains all the descriptions about the product, such as price, quality, grade, quantity, mode of delivery, type of packing, payment, terms and conditions, etc. Then receipt of indent or order. The next step in export process is to get the receipt of order. In domestic trade, which the buyer sent to the seller is termed as order. But that order in international business is known as indent. Okay, and the quotation which is sent by the exporter to the importer is also known as performa invoice. Now he will receive the indent, means order. This order will contain all the details about the requirement of the importer, like how much the quantity, at what rate, at what size, shape, design, what are the terms and conditions of payment, packaging and transportation. Everything is discussed here, and then accordingly he will send the order, means indent. When the exporter receives the indent, then he will assess importer's creditworthiness and securing a guarantee for payment. Means letter of credit, means the exporter is not ready to send the goods easily. First, he wants to minimize his risk factor. He wants to satisfy or assured about the promptness of payment. So he required that letter of credit or guarantee payment. So letter of credit is a guarantee given by the importer's bank that he will honor. They will give the payment of a specified amount to the specified banker on that date. The date is also mentioned, or the amount and everything is mentioned. So the exporter is satisfied with all the situations. Then next is obtaining export license. To get the export license from the import export licensing authority, the exporter has to fulfill some formalities, because in every country for export and import business, one code password or license is necessary. Without license and code or password, they cannot do the international trade. That's why they should apply for license, and the authorities are there, government officials are there who will issue the license. Then for license, what should we do if you want to do the export-import business? For license, first of all, there should be a bank account, PAN card, Aadhaar number. Aadhaar card is necessary nowadays, PAN card, bank account. These all are KYC also. So for obtaining export-import code or IEC from the Directorate General of Foreign Trade or Regional Import-Export Licensing Authority, the export-import license code is necessary. That will be issued by the government official. We can say Directorate General of Foreign Trade issued that. Then some councils are established for specific products, so that is also required. Now, Credit and Guarantee Corporation is there to cover the risk of non-payment. Export procedure, next step, when the exporter applied for license, the next step is obtaining pre-shipment finance. See, each step is there, that's why it is known as process. We have to follow every step, like first query, then performer, then indent, then LOC. LOC, after LOC means assurance from bank payment, then IEC number, export import code number means license is necessary. When the exporter got the license, then he will not wait. He will start production, but before production, he requires some finance. So obtaining pre-shipment finance, then he will approach to the bank to get the finance and to carry out the export production. Then when he will get the finance from the bank or from other sources, other financial institutions are also set up by the government, then he will start production or procurement of goods. When he is ready to produce the goods, either by production or by purchasing. See, procurement means he will purchase from someone and sell to the other one. So that's why in between he will work as a mediator, that will be exchange. Okay. So production means he will start production then in the factory. Then pre-shipment inspection. See, this is necessary in international business. When we differentiate these two, that is necessary. In domestic trade, no one is there to inspect your products. Generally, that is based on faith. But for international trade, it is necessary to check the quality, because this is the image of the country also. So the officials will come there to check the goods, and this is by the government one. Authority is there, that is Export Inspection Agency, EIA. They will check your goods. Now, excise clearance. Then the authorities persons will come and check the quality, and they do the inspection. Then the next step is excise clearance. Now, if he will get the certificate from inspection authority, then the Central Excise and Tariff Act. Generally, it is necessary for goods exported, and then after they will refund it also. So the excise commissioner will check the excise clearance. Then if the authority is satisfied, then the excise clearance is given. and that his duty drawback scheme means the amount which he paid will be refunded. Then when excise commissioner gave him the export clearance or excise clearance certificate, means he will be assured that his goods are according to the orders, according to the quality norms, then he will, exporter will obtain certificate of origin. Certificate of origin is a proof that the goods are actually being produced in the country from where it is exported. Okay, so some importing countries provide tariff concession or other exemptions from some countries. So certificate of origin is proof that the goods are being produced in that country from where it is exported. That's why it is known as certificate of origin. Okay, certificate of origin is necessary because that is the proof that the goods produced in some specific country. And why it is necessary? This is an interesting point. Why that certificate of origin is necessary? Because many countries in the world are giving tax exemptions, free trade facilities due to globalization, free trade facilities to those who have good relations with them, or to those who have good image over there. So generally, to avail the benefits, okay? And to get this benefit, they have to submit their certificate of origin with the other documents. So certificate of origin is necessary to get the tariff concession and to get the benefits from the certain countries. And it is a proof. The next, when you clear by the excise department, you get the certificate of origin. What exporter will have to do? Yes, now he will start ready to send the goods. So he will reserve a shipping space. See, for international trade, airways or shipping is used. So generally for heavy goods, that is shipping. So on port, there are some authorities, some agencies are there. So now the exporter has to apply for this by furnishing complete information about the goods. What are the dates he required? Which port of destination he wants? From where he wants to load that goods? So that is port of destination. Shipping then, when the shipping company is ready, then they will issue a shipping order. Okay, this is known as a shipping order. Now shipping order, it is an instructions to the captain of the ship that they specify goods after custom clearance at a designated port be received on board. Means that is also cleared by the shipping company. This is known as a shipping order and it is an instruction to the captain of the ship. Then after securing date, place of the shipping company and complete for information, then the exporter will do is start packing and forward. First of all, goods are packed and marked with detail. Complete details he will put on it, like what is the name, what is the address of the importer, what is the weight, designation, destination port means from to which country he wants to send, name of country of importer as well as name of country of origin means exporter, means everything he has to mark, like handle with care, perishable goods, please take care. In this way, everything, what is the quantity, who is the sender, who is the receiver, who is importer, who is exporter, what are the goods inside it, everything with complete documents. That is also the work of exporter. Packing list is necessary. It contains all the details. Then, when see, even in domestic market, we minimize our risk factor. Then why not in international trade? Okay, so in international trade, insurance of goods is necessary. So to cover the all the risk due to sea barriers in transit, the exporter has to issue all the goods. Okay, then custom clearance. Before loading the goods on the ship, custom clearance should be obtained by the exporter. He will prepare shipping bill. Shipping bill will be prepared in 5 copies. See, the exporter packed the goods, insured the goods, then he will send it, forward it. Then there will be custom clearance department on the port. They will, before loading the on the goods, they will check everything. And they will then 5 shipping bills copy is to be prepared. Shipping bill means is a document that contains complete detail of the goods, name of the ship, destination port, exporting, importing countries means origin, that importer's country also, exporter's name and address, everything is given on shipping bill. Okay, then shipping bill is to be attached with the for custom clearance. These documents, what is the order, LOC received or not, because this is the proof of payment. Then invoice means the complete detail of bill, the certificate of origin to get the concessions, certificate of inspection by the authorities because it is necessary, then insurance policy, because without insurance no company will take your goods now. Then based on the above document, the port authorities, will issue a carting order. Carting order means it is the instruction in written form to the staff at the gate of the port to allow the cargo inside the dock. Okay, this is the instruction to the staff, or it is known as gate pass. Then obtaining mate's receipt. After the goods are loaded on the ship, the captain or mate of the ship issues a certificate that is known as mate's receipt. Means when the goods are loaded on the ship, then a certificate is issued as a proof that the goods are loaded on the ship, received by the shipping company. This is the proof that you are sending the goods. This is known as mate's receipt. Please see, it is a receipt issued by the captain or mate of the ship as an acknowledgement of the receipt of goods in the ship, which contains the name of ship, berth, date of shipment, description of packages, condition of cargo, etc. Means that will contain the complete detail. Then when you receive that mate's receipt, the payment of freight and insurance of bill of lading, means CNF agents are there on the port, so clearing and forwarding agents are there, we submit mate's receipt to the shipping company and then they will compute the freight according to the weight, then they will take the payment, and then after the payment of freight, the shipping company issues a bill of lading. This is a proof that exporter paid freight, okay, and cargo is loaded on the ship. This is the ultimate proof that this ship is taking that product at that destination, Okay, quantity, quality, name of sender, name of receiver, everything is written on it. That's why now the shipping company is responsible to deliver the goods. Okay, now see, in case if it is sent by document by the air, it is known as airway bill. This is the difference. If the good is light in weight, perishable like medicines, injections, etc., then if you are sending the goods by the air, then it is known as airway bill. Preparation of invoice. Now, the last stage. Coming to the last stage, what is the aim of exporter? To send the goods and get the payment and earn the profits. That's the basic reason. So up to here, he sent the bill, sent the goods. Now he will prepare the invoice. Then now exporter has to prepare an invoice of the goods which contains the details such as quantity and amount to be paid. Then when he sent the bill, prepare the invoice, the next is securing payment. Then at the end, exporter will send the complete details to the importer, all documents. Okay, then he will receive the payment. This is the last stage. Here I am showing you export process at a glance, receipt of inquiry, means inquiry received, and accordingly he will send the performa invoice. Then order or indent will be sent by the importer to the exporter. Then he will check the credit worthiness, financial position. Then he will apply for license. Then he will get the finance, collect the sources of finance, check the sources of finance. Then he will start production or procurement for exchange. Then authorities will come for inspection. They will give the excise clearance. Then he will obtain certificate of origin for getting some concessions. Then after that, shipping space to be reserved. After reservation, he will start packing, then forward it. But insurance is necessary. Then on the port, custom department will clear. Then they will issue mates received, then freight to be paid, then bill of lading will be received. This is the proof that goods are going. Then exporter will prepare the invoice, attach all the documents, then at the end he will get the payment. This is the process export, we can say. So it's easy to learn if you will learn through sequence.